tree, 500 years old, maybe a reincarnation, I don't know, but the same tree, same place. And so this is a place where Nityananda Prabhu would every day come out with his boyfriends, and they would have play. But their play was very interesting. They would play Krishna Leela, Ram Leela, different Avatar Leela, Baraha Leela, Narasingha Leela. Every day they would come out, and the elders would watch them, and they would all take their different roles and play the parts. And they wondered, how do five-year-old kids know all these dramas? You know, like our Chaitanya Dasi and Jayada Radhika and others who train children to do drama. It takes a lot to choreograph them and train them and everything. But these kids, they just did it spontaneously. And they knew all the exact role. Must be they were in all the leelas before, because they were all eternal associates of the Lord. And Nityananda is Balaram. He was Lakshman in Ram Leela. And so it said that Lakshman was tired every time Ram was giving him orders as the older brother. Said, next time I'm going to be take birth as the elder brother. As the younger brother. The older brother was Ram. He always was ordering him. So next birth he took as Balaram. Now he was older brother. 1 year older than Krishna. So there's this is all already explained in great detail in the Chaitanya Bhagavat, these childhood pastimes of Nityananda. It gives one example, one pastime in detail, which is out from my basis of Srila Prabhupada, that they were playing Ram Leela that day. And Nityananda was playing Lakshman, and other boys were playing Ram and Hanuman and everything. And this was the time when they had the battle with Indrajit, who had a special poison arrow, and he hit Lakshman, who fell unconscious. And just at that time, Mother Padmavati came and said, lunchtime, everyone come home. But then Lakshman, which is Lord Nityananda, he's lying down unconscious because he's playing the part. This drama is already serious business. So then the mother got hysterical. What happened to my son? He's unconscious, he's not breathing because he's playing the pastime of the poison arrow. And then she called for the doctor and called for the father, and nobody could do anything. Then the father said, what were you doing when this happened? They said, we were playing the drama, and he was playing Lakshman. He got hit by the arrow. I said, what comes next? Let's go on with the drama. Let's finish the drama. And then they said, well, Hanuman goes and brings the mountain of herbs. So where's Hanuman? You go, bring the mountain of herbs. And they did it to finish the pastime and brought the mountain. Then Ram came and took the magic herb and gave it to Nityananda, and he came conscious. So their pastime, they were really reliving all these pastimes here every day for so many, for 5-7 years, ever since from 5 till 12. That was his daily. So this is a very holy place. I mean, and there's still the same dust here. It's not, we usually come here, we take a dust on our head, or some devotees roll in the ground, because Nityananda, with all these eternal associates from Golok Vrindavan, they came here and they had these pastimes every day. So this is a very special place. I'm still, every time I come here, I'm thinking, oh, we almost got it. Would have been a wonderful place to have and develop. But they didn't want us to get any place here. We got the place by the side of the Jamuna, which is also a nice place. Some pastimes happen there. But they have their own mood. Like, they didn't want to have any electricity here. They said They don't like preaching. They like just the bhajan, keep it silent, no loudspeaker, no. So they have a different mood, and ISKCON has a mood. We're trying to spread the message of Nityananda. Nityananda would go everywhere and request everyone to chant Hare Krishna. But anyway, what we can do? At least they left the tree here. This is... So I don't know what type of time bound, what type of... Huh? There's an interesting pastime where Nityananda Prabhu, after delivering Madai came to him and apologized. He said that I offended you. I hit you with a, you know, you didn't offend me. You know, I hit you with a wine bottle. I caused you injury. I want to be forgiven for my offense. And then Nityananda said, no, I love you. Just like a mother loves his child. And the mother's holding the baby child and the baby child hits the mother or kicks the mother. Mother doesn't take any offense. So for me, it was like that type of thing. Just like a child hitting the mother. That's Nityananda's mood. I mean, someone comes with this clay wine bottle and hits him on the head, and he said it's like a baby tapping me with the foot. Get an idea how merciful Nityananda Prabhu is. And then Madai said that, well, Nityananda said, I'm not taking any offense. He said, but I made so many other offenses to other people. I was a criminal. I was robbing Damvasis. I was persecuting Brahmanas. I was doing so many horrible things. So what about all this offense I made to other Jivas? He said, aha, that's true. So you should do something to help people in their spiritual life. If you help people in their spiritual life, then you'll get forgiven for the offenses you made against them. So what can I do? He said, well, maybe you can build a ghat, a bathing stairway into the Ganges and facilitate people to come down to the Ganges and bathe, making their approach to the Ganges easier. So in this way you'll get forgiven for your offenses. So on the month of April, May, when it's the lowest peak and the lowest level of the Ganges and it's the hottest weather, then you can make the stairway right at the lowest point. Then Madai was out there with a hand shovel and a hoe and everything, and with bricks and stones, and he constructed a ghat for the residents of Navadvip as his prize chitya for all the offenses. So that became one of the main five ghats in Navadvip called Madai Ghat. So that was one pastime Nityananda. Pastime of Birchandra, Nityananda's son. Once he brought his kirtan party to the king of the Nawab in Goud, and the Nawab arrested him and said, I heard you're, you know, you're converting people or you're preaching. People say you're a saint. So you have to prove to me you're a saint. If you can prove to me you're a saint, then I'll give you a gift. But if you can't prove to me you're a saint, then I'll kill you. The proof is my sister has gone mad. You make her sane, then I'll free you. And all the doctors in the kingdom had tried, nobody could make her sane. So Birchandra went and cured her insanity. She became a devotee. And then the emperor was pleased. He said, okay, what do you want? You're a real saint, you're a real peer. He said, I just want a stone. It was a black stone from your the wall of your fortress. And he said, a black stone in my fortress wall, what's that? So let me show me. And then they went out, he showed there was a big, maybe 6 feet by 6-7 feet by, you go up feet or meters? Your feet, right? I don't know exactly how, it was big, it was took like a, it was very big, because it was big enough to make three large deities, so three deities, not two large and one, two, one small. So must have been about 7-8 feet wide by a meter long by a meter. No, more than a meter. It must have been 4 meters. No, not four, but feet. 4 or 5 feet wide by maybe a yard, something like that. It was a big stone right in the middle of the wall. So he said, how can you take that out of my wall? My whole wall will fall down. Anyway, so I can take it out, no problem, your wall won't fall down. Just say that if I can have it or not. Yeah, you can take it. So then the devotees did kirtan, and the stone was like a gigantic shaligram shila. And it popped out of the wall. And then Pichanda said, please take the stone to the Ganges. But it took elephants to pull the stone, many elephants, many people. And they took it to the side of the Ganges, up by Kanai Natsala. And then he said, wrap it with straw. So they wrapped the stone with straw, and I said, throw it into the water. So what's it, crazy? We did all that work, and we're throwing it in the water. Just throw it in the water. Since Birchandra Prabhu is the Kirodaksai Vishnu, he's the one who's keeping all the planets floating. So then the stone floated in the Ganges like a balloon. This heavy stone that these elephants were pulling, and now it was floating. And it is in the Birchandra told it where to go, and it went down to his house near Panihati in Kordaha. And there he asked a sculptor to make a deity. He made Ranwara Balab deity, but he said it was too, because he had a vision of this deity, he says too small. He said, you gotta make it bigger. They made another deities, but they were too big. There was only one piece left. He said, better get it right now in between. And that deity is Radha Shyam Sundar. So if that's the deity at the temple of the birthplace of Lord Birchandra Prabhu and the house of Nityananda. So Birchandra, he was preaching here in north, and this is just a little beyond this is North Bengal, beyond the Ganges. This place is called Radish. R-A-D-H, but the R is with a dot, like a, with a dot under it. Radish. Rad, not Radadish, but Radish. And it's the place, the Ganges doesn't flow here. So this Nityananda appeared here to give blessing. These people are deprived from the Ganges, so his presence blessed all of them. So Maharaj, you going to tell them about those trees over there in that house? That's where the Pandavas stayed in their 1 year of Agyatavas. When there were, he knows the details, I think, better, but that they were staying there for 1 year, or for a part of the time. It's mentioned also in the Navadip Dham Mahatmya that they were staying in Navadip for some time, the Pandavas, and they came here. I can't remember now, they came here, went there, or they went there and came here. It's, where's our Brajanath? Huh? Which was first? Here, then they went to Navadip. Nityananda's blessing first and then go to get Gaur's blessing. So Pandavas also visited Navadvip in a place called Mahatpur. But they were first here, Nityananda's birthplace. You gonna go over there or are you gonna tell it from here? Or tell it?
So next we'll go take darshan of the place known as Pandavtala. In Mahabharata it has been explained the Pandavas, they came here when they were exiled, they had to stay something 1 year or something like that. He was waiting in Vrindavan until Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu started his Sankirtan movement. One day, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he came to Srivas Thakur house. He told, you know, I saw a dream today. What is that dream? I saw a very great personality. He was telling, you know, within few days, a great personality will come. One day, he said, early morning, he came, he said, I saw a dream. The dream I saw, a big chariot, Taladhoja chariot. On top of the chariot, there's a personality sitting. Huge figure he has. He's wearing blue cloth, he has a turban, he has a plow, club, and he has one earring. So what happened to the other earring that is connected to this Pandavas? What happened one day when Nityananda was staying here, along with his younger brother, he went to his uncle's house, some other village, uncle's house. So both brothers were staying. The villagers, so one day, he said, his younger brother, let's go to the forest, let's have a walk in the forest. The villagers, they say, hey, don't go there, there's a snake inside the forest. Anybody goes, snake biting will be killed. But Nityananda Prabhu, he did not care because what a snake can do to him. He himself is the Ananta. Ananta is Pap, you know. He's a partial incarnation of Nityananda Prabhu. So he went there. Then when both the brother went, the snake came. Then Nityananda, hey, what are you doing here? Who are you? Why are you disturbing people here? Then the snake was explaining how he came over there. The Pandavas are staying here. As you know this story, at least you must have watched Mahabharata from the TV. From there at least you would know. The Pandavas are staying. That time there is a demon. What is demon's name? Bakasur. He was eating everybody. Then they had a contract that every family will give one person for him to eat. And that term came, this Brahman family has to send one person. So Pancha Pandavas, they have gone out. The Brahman and his son, they are fighting with each other. Son saying, I should go, so that the demon can eat me. Brahman saying, no, you should stay, I should go. No, Brahman can eat me. So each family, they have to send one bullock cart full of foodstuffs and two buffaloes, and one person has to go. The demon will have his happy time, feast. So then when Kunti mother, Kunti heart, they are fighting, they are talking like this, what happened to you? What is happening? Then they explain, this is the situation. Then mother Kunti said, you don't be worried, you have only one son, but I have five sons, I can give one of my son. The demon can eat one of my son, but Kunti Devi knows who will eat whom. Then one of his son goes, what will happen? Then she told Bhimsen, you please go, this has happened, he described. Then Bhimsen was very much interested to go. Specifically, he came to know that whole bullock cart of cakes and fruits will go. So I'll have at least happy time with that. So bullock cart, the Bhimsen went, and then he started to eat everything. And the demon came, there's a place, that place is still there. The Bhimsen and the demon are fighting, that land is still there. The vigorous fighting was going on, there are big holes are there also, that area. Then Bhimsen went to, and Bhimsen killed. In the meantime, Arjun came. And mother Kunti told Arjun, this is what has happened, Bhimsen has gone to fight with this demon. Then Arjun got very worried. He had gone alone, what is happening? whether he can fight properly or not. So Arjun sitting in the house, he shoot an arrow, one serpent arrow, Nagafas, Naga serpent arrow. He shoot it out to kill the demon in the middle of Bhimsan came. You are here, what happened to the demon? Yes, I killed the demon. And Arjun got very worried. Arjun, but I sent this Naga arrow. Naga arrow goes there, it has to kill somebody, but you have already killed. Then Arjun immediately went, pacified Naga, that you stay here. Then he was staying, he said, that is the Naga, I am staying here. From that time, and I have been blessed. Anybody, I will not go anywhere, but anybody come here, I will eat them. So from that time, anybody comes here, the village, anybody, I eat them. But Nityananda said, no, from today, you don't eat anybody. Yeah, they will come and give you bhoga, offering. So you go stay inside this hole. Then Naga went, entered inside the hole. Then Nityananda took his ring, and covered the hole. So Naga cannot come. That ring is still there now. Is it growing?
They had a lot of land here. So one day, Bankari was told that you should bring food for the people that are working in the field. So he was a little indifferent, he's a little late to bring this food to the field. And all those people that are working, they're very angry, why it is late. So the work was not progressing. And Bankara came, they got on his case. Bankara said, you don't be worried. I'll work for you very quickly, you'll finish. The work was, they have to take all the weights, you know, weights, unnecessary things. Immediately the boy developed hundreds of hands, and removing all the weights from the field. Then gradually, they said that he entered into that place. And Hatu Goda, he put his Hatu. Then they removed the weights, they put his Hatu, and he entered there and disappeared. And finally, he appeared in a deity form, Bankarai, in Kadambakhandi, that river next to our land. A small river, Jamuna River. And the trees, Lord Nityananda used to jump from the tree into the river and take a bath. And from there, Kardambakhandi, Kardama means the mud, Kardama, and mud. So he appeared from there. And this afternoon, after we take prasadam, before we start our journey, we can walk up to Bankara temple and take darshan there. And actually, we had no place here. Today you have seen what kind of behavior we get from this temple. It's not only to us, to everybody is like that. Though that is main place, in festivities days, more people come to our place than this place. Sanatana Gauranga was telling once a year, Panditananda Trayadasi. And we are not able to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra also. So finally, fortunately, by BSCT, Prabhupada has established a Bhakti Vedanta Swami Charity Trust. We got a small piece of land, we had a small house. Now we have bought more land there. And we got all the land next to Jamuna River. And also the Kadamakhandi also will come in our area also. So we are planning to... We had a desire to have a temple, not big temple, small temple. So last time I went to UK, so Madan Mohan Prabhu was just giving me a donation. So you please take it for the maintenance of your Ekacakra temple. Then I just mentioned to him, okay, I'll keep it, I'll save this money so that someday we can build a small temple there. He's giving me 500 to save. And I said, then he said, oh, you want to build a temple? How much it will cost? I said, 30 lakhs rupees, 25, 30 lakhs rupees, a small one. So okay, we must build a temple there then. Okay. Then he gave some fund. Then your treasurer, what is his name? Other Prabhu? Nila Madhava is here. Gave some funds. So we are planning to have a small temple. So from here we will go and we will do some Bhumi Puja. We'll take this look half an hour, some yajna. And then after Bhumi Puja, we'll take bath or fresh, then take prasadam, lunch prasadam. After lunch prasadam, if there is time, we'll have some katha. If no time, we'll walk and do kirtan and walk to the Bankara temple. Yeah, there no problem. There goes, there is another group. They are very, very happy with us. We have spent, BSC has spent money to repair the temple and everything. We have very good relationship with Bankara temple. And there is a nice Jagannath temple also. There is Shiva temple. The Harai Pandit was pujari of that Shiva temple. This is very nice pastimes took place there, next to Bankara temple also. If you have any question, any of you have. You understood how we spoke? You have understood, no? You have understood everything that we, what we have spoken. Sriti, you want to say anything? You want to add? He was here for up to 12 years, then he went to that sannyasi, then he went all the tirtha places all over the world, from Kanyakumari all the way up to Badrinath, he's moving. Then finally he was waiting in Vrindavan, he was staying in Vrindavan. Then when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started the Sankirtan movement, in Nandan Acharya there is a place, maybe that description that Maharaj gives.
Nityananda had a vision that Lord Chaitanya has that Kanai. Lord Krishna had come and he was as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he started the Sankirtan movement. So now it was, he was waiting for that, then he would come and join. So then he went to Govardhan. And in Govardhan, Sridham, one of the main cowherd sakas, he never went back to Godhead. He had stayed there, was resting or whatever, 5,000 years for eternal people, it's nothing. And so he called and outside the cave, Sridham! 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 And then, you know, Sridham was woken up by Nityananda's loud calling, came. But it's Dwapara Yuga people were bigger, and Kali Yuga were smaller. So Nityananda looked small to him. Even though he was only a cowherd boy, but he was big. And so he said, who are you? He said, I'm Balai. Balai, but Balai looked different. He said, now it's Kali Yuga, I come here like this to join. Then he said, well, prove it to me. When we race around Govardhan Hill, the only one who could beat me was Balai, Balaram. Balaram's nickname is Balai, and Krishna's nickname is Kanai. Krishna Kanai Dauji Kabaiya. So Balai is another name for Dauji, for Balaram. So then immediately Sridham started racing around Govardhan. Nityananda was running with him. So the two are having a race to prove who is if he's really Balaram or not. So they went around the first side, going around the far corner, coming around through the back, coming in all the way, and then for the third quarter, coming around, then kind of final and the finish line, and it was Nityananda! Then Sridham said, okay, I agree, you're Nityananda, you're Balaram. But what do you want? What are you doing here? And he said, you see, Kanai came as Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and he's spreading love of Godhead to everyone, giving the Sankirtan movement. And right now he started the Sankirtan movement in Bengal, in Navadvip. I'm going to go there and join him. You want to come along and join the pastimes? You want to come and join me with Kanai? Of course, let's go. Okay, look it. You got to change your form. You're not set up for Kali Yuga. So then he put his hand on the top of Sridham's head and squished him down. Turn him into a Kali Yuga human being form. And then he became Abhiram Thakur. Sri Ram Abhiram, Abhiram Thakur. Ram Abhiram. He was an incarnation of Sridham, but he never died. He just transformed by Nityananda. Then he came with Nityananda, and they met in Navadvip. That's another whole long story. Sometime I can tell you that one. How they met and for the first time in Navadvip next to the Mayapur temple. So when you go, like we just opened a new temple in Tirunelveli, now south of Madurai in southern near Konyakumari in southern Tamil Nadu. And Nityananda visited there. Lord Chaitanya visited all the holy places. Because the holy places get stocked up with sins. You're probably dropping a few off here as you come. But you don't have any sins, but in case you have any few, you might drop them off. So by the Holy Lord coming, He frees the place from, you know, cleans out all the garbage. Everything is clean again, re-sanctifies it. So whenever the Lord comes, one of His pastimes is to visit. So Balaram visited the holy places during Kurukshetra War. He visited Mayapur, He visited Navadvip, they say visited here also. And Lord Nityananda, 4,500 years later, He visited the holy places. Lord Chaitanya also visited many holy places. And while we're chanting Hare Krishna, that's also helping to purify. Said that the holy name is incarnation of Krishna in sound. So we come here to get purified. You see, like, in the places of Vrindavan were like this 500 years ago. When Lord Chaitanya went, Radhakund was a puddle. And then it was devotees under the six Goswamis' direction, businessmen and devotees. They actually fixed up Vrindavan, built the different temples. So now Vrindavan has so many temples, the Radha Govinda, Radha Madan Mohan, Radha Damodar, and so on. Bunky Bihari and whatnot, but that's more popular temple. Not one of the seven. So all these holy temples were built by devotees and holy places were discovered by the six Goswamis. But here in Bengal, now the devotees of Lord Chaitanya are awakening up around the world. But so many of these holy places are not developed yet. I mean, there's no... They're just like you have to use your imagination. What was in some of the places? There's a ruins. So in the future, Prabhupada, he wanted that all the holy places in Bengal and Navadvip Dham, they should be developed to receive the pilgrims. It's like have a nice Nath Mandir or something where now you're sitting here, if it was a rainy day, where would you sit? Sometime we come here in April, it's very hot. So that's one of the sevas, to develop the holy places so that it can receive the devotees. As we increase making devotees around the world and in Europe and Americas and South America and Africa and Australasia and Asia, then they come and visit the holy places, but there should be some facility for them. So that when they come, they can sit down, hear the kathas, they can worship the Lord. So, part of Bhaktivedanta Swami Charity Trust, that's called the Bhaktivedanta Swami Charity, BSCT mentioned, Bhaktivedanta Swami Charity Trust, Prabhupada put a 10% of his Guru Dakshin for developing the holy places in Gaurmandal Bhumi, the pastime places of Lord Chaitanya Nityananda. But that, it's a very small amount. It's like 1 lakh a year, somehow. Because it's the interest of 10%. It's not 10%, it's the interest of 10%. At that time he had... the rupee has, what do you call it, devaluated? At that time it was $1 million, maybe he had, and 10%. Was 100,000, and 10% of that was 10,000. That time it was a lakh of rupees, because it was like 7 rupees per the dollar. Now rupees, 45 rupees per the dollar. Something like that. Anyway, we still get, then we get other donations. But with that, we try to, where ISKCON is personally present, then ISKCON personally develops things. And then we manage it and we take care. When there's someone else, like this Bunky Rai temple, it's their temple, so we give them a donation, or we personally do the work. The wall was cracked, or the floor was cracked, or we fixed the floor. We used to give them money, and then they would spend on other things. So now we send our own people and fix it up. So we've done certain temples, the fixing up different temples in Navadweep, the Dameshwar Mandir, also the Jagannath Das Babaji, the Mamgachi Temple, the Belpukur Temple. And we've done, and then in other parts of Gormandal Bhumi we've done. But now we see that in addition, there are places which are not developed or the local temples are not able to do anything. But we need also to have ISKCON temples. So that's why we wanted that we have this temple here, because otherwise there's nowhere. The Gaudiya Mats ask us, please make a branch, make something in Nityananda Dham, because the other Gaudiyas, they can't even come here. I mean, there's nowhere for them to stay. There's no for the, so that's why we started it. But this house that we have now, it's already gets complete. It's already like an ashram, and it's filled up. When we bring out devotees, they put a tarpaulin on the roof. And one year we were there, and the roof, the tarpaulin blew away by a storm, and all that. It was. In the future, they need a guest house here also for or something, some campsite or something. But that's where now ISKCON does some place, some holy places. Like we have Haridaspur, which is Haridas Thakur's pastime place by the Bangladesh border. We have something here, Nityananda Dham. We have Kanai Nachala, which is where Lord Chaitanya visited three times and first saw the love of Godhead. It'd be nice to take them one year to Kanai Nachala. Maybe it'd be too austere for them. Oh yeah, I'll let you decide that. Sachinandan Maharaj said he wanted a place where he could hide away to write books and do bhajan. So I told him Kanai Nachala. He was there for 1 month. You can find out from him how he liked it. There's electricity. Little bit. Token. End of the line. It's a little hillock over the Ganges. The Ganges there, because of the Faraka barrage, is about 15 kilometers wide, like 10 miles wide. So you're on a hill looking over the Ganges. It's very beautiful. And that's where Lord Chaitanya first manifested love for Godhead in his pastimes. So like this, we're trying to, when we get these holy places, then we think it's an opportunity for us, a special mercy. And so that's why we thought we should have something here. And we really appreciate that some of you are coming forward to help develop, because we don't have so many resources. But this is special, very dear to me, because I know that Prabhupada wanted to see Lord Chaitanya Nityananda's pastime places develop. We're discussing now about developing something in Panihati. Someone's offered us a temple right nearby, just a few hundred meters from the tree of the Panihati. So I often come to the Mayapur manager and say, we got to take this temple, we need some pujaris or some devotees. And usually Bhakti Purushottamara is very favorable. Very considerate about these things.
So I think because you're late, there's nothing much to see. You can just see from here. But I want to introduce a nice devotee to you. He's Tapagauranga Das Prabhu. He's from Calcutta. He has a factory businessman, but his house is originally from nearby city, Saintia. So who's helping for this temple, and lot of land also he bought. So you should pray Lord Nityananda for his special spiritual welfare. Hariva! Hariva! Hariva!
His family has china clay. So some of the teacups that you're drinking from, the clay was from his money.
So we should do.
Once you take hot milk, the tea is okay.
So we should have kirtan, then.
Bhumi Puja ceremony is going on now in Ekacakra, the best place of Nityananda. On the 30th of January 2006, inaugurated by Srila Jayapataka Swami a devotee from England.
Om namo narayana swami Om namo narayana swami Om namo narayana swami Om namo narayana swami Om namo narayana
Oh, Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.